linear interpolation, where we simply connect each point by a linear line, is one of the easier forms of interpolation and the one that we're going to look at today. So what we have here is between each of these points, we are approximating the equation y is equal to mx plus c. From our x value, the known value, we would then look up to this equation, which we are now going to determine. And from that equation, we can then solve and find our y value. The idea now is to look at this equation, y is equal to mx plus c, and how do we solve that between these two points of interest, as I've got in the graph? From that, how are we going to then get the y, our unknown y, to solve this equation? You're possibly going to come across a couple of ways to solve this. The one that I'm going to look at, though, is I'm going to assume that we have point x1, y1 on the left, and point x2, y2 on the right. Let's just rub these other ones out because we're not going to be doing interpolation between those two for now. At that, those are known values, which, as I say, we often read from a table. We are given an x, so x is known, and we want to know what is the y value here. So our y in green is our unknown. In my mind, the easiest way to solve this is to recognize that at x1, y1, or between x1, y1, up to point x2, y2, we have a graph. Y is equal to mx plus c with a value, a slope of m. Between x1, y1 and up to our point of xy, our unknown known system, we have a straight line y is equal to mx plus c, where that m is also the same m, the same slope. So if we had to look at that and calculate the slope of the first line, we're going to have the change in y over the change in x for the black line there. So that was y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So that's the slope of the black line from each of the endpoints. And that will be equal to the green line where we have now y, that's the unknown value, minus y1, which is given, divided by x minus x1. If we then rearrange that, we can write this as x minus x1. So we're taking this bottom bit and we're moving it over to the left, multiplied by y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 is equal to, just neaten that up a little bit, is then equal to y minus y1. All of those values, let's just highlight them. The y2, y1, x2, x1 are known from our interpolation. They repeat it again, x1 and y1. The question will state, what is the y value at a specific x? So that's the x I've got in yellow. So the only unknown is that y there. Rearranging that and putting the y on the left, we will have y is equal to a positive y1, we're taking it across to the other side, plus x minus x1 multiplied by y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So there we now have our Newton formula for y, our unknown, equal to y1 plus x, which is our given value, minus x1, multiplied by y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, which are both values on either end of our interpolation value.